The fields of dam engineering and construction have evolved over the years, from hand-built earthen berms of early civilizations to today's technologically advanced megastructures. The state of the art is always evolving due to innovations in engineering and, unfortunately, in response to tragic structural failures that bring lessons learned and needed improvements. In the United States, regulation and emergency action preparations are now considered by professionals to be essential tools in ensuring the safety of dams and downstream communities. From the mid-1800s to the 1930s, there was little regulatory oversight in the U.S. for dam construction, and little was understood about the unique challenges and complexities of dam engineering. By 1940, even as dams were getting more colossal, only 11 U.S. states had laws regulating the safety of dams, and that number only went up to 24 by 1970. This era can be considered Dam Safety 1.0, a period when we began recognizing the need for regulatory oversight and engineering consensus to solidify dam safety standards. Several high-profile failures and one key piece of legislation, the National Dam Safety Inspection Act of 1972, brought the U.S. into the next era of Dam Safety 2.0. Federal guidelines were developed, and an inventory, including private, state, and federal dams, was established. A model law was created, and many states adopted some form of it, bringing most of the nation's dams under state or federal oversight. Over the next few decades, almost every state adopted dam safety laws. These regulations primarily focused on regular inspections of dams and emergency action plans that could be implemented in the event of imminent failure. Some state regulations included requiring permits for new dam construction, minimum standards for repairs to existing structures, enforcement powers, and annual fees. 2.0 was an era of capacity building, improved education, improvements to laws and regulations, and national communication and coordination across levels of government and within the private sector. With improvements to how dams, dam ownership, and regulation were viewed came successes. More funding was going toward dam safety programs, metrics showed state regulatory agencies were improving, and fewer high-profile destructive dam failures were occurring. Now, decades later, the industry is again considering its collective performance in keeping dams safe. Are we now in era 3.0? Lessons learned from the Oroville Dam spillway incident of 2017 and the Edenville and Sanford Dam failures of 2020 are pushing the industry to make changes in the way inspections are performed and moving toward comprehensive reviews. Professionals are reconsidering the way we understand risk and how that affects regulatory oversight and rehabilitation. Additionally, the industry is beginning to develop a deeper understanding of how dams affect the environment and how dam removal should be considered within the dam safety decision-making process. This video will summarize some of the modern practices and considerations that many owners, engineers, and even regulators are employing to ensure the utmost safety, resilience, and sustainability of dam structures today. Dam Safety 3.0. Although a critical part of any dam safety plan, physical inspections are not always sufficient to identify and manage concerns. The field of dam engineering has progressed significantly, and many dams no longer stand up to modern standards. An inspection can only identify problems that have already started. Many dam owners are enhancing inspections with comprehensive reviews. This includes a detailed look at a dam's original design and construction, checking design criteria, assumptions, and sometimes even engineering parameters and calculations. A comprehensive review considers long-term performance, failure mode analysis, historical maintenance, and improvements in repairs. It also assesses appurtenant structures like spillways and outlets, since failures of those structures can be consequential. A comprehensive review can provide fresh consideration of all aspects of a dam through the lens of modern engineering and dam safety, especially for older dams which often don't meet advanced standards of today. It can reveal unseen failure modes and identify potential problems that a physical inspection might miss. Owners and regulators are recognizing the impacts of climate change on dams. Shifts in long-term weather patterns and hydrology can impact dams by making both floods and droughts more severe and rainfall more seasonal. Many dams were designed for hydrologic conditions that are already significantly different than those that exist now. Owners and regulators must consider what the future might hold and how climate change might impact the loading conditions, storage, operation, and maintenance of dams over the long term. Now let's place a dam safety 3.0 lens on the costs and benefits of a dam. As dams get older, their maintenance and rehabilitation costs go up, but their benefits to the public don't always follow. If an owner doesn't have the resources to repair or rehabilitate their dam, they can end up in a stalemate with regulators without a clear path forward. Dams often have many stakeholders, which can make decision-making even more complicated. For example, the property owners around a reservoir may have a strong interest in maintaining a dam, even if they have no financial responsibility for its upkeep. Regulators are recognizing the need for innovation both in aligning the benefits and costs of maintaining a dam safely and in the opportunities for funding improvements, including grant programs and public-private partnerships. In addition, we're getting better at recognizing when the costs of maintaining a dam and its impacts to the environment have grown to outweigh its benefits to the public. Dam removal is a valid choice, and one that's becoming more common and accepted as the regulatory and engineering hurdles associated with these projects diminish. Technological advancements are already revolutionizing the way we monitor and manage dams. Many dams are fitted with instruments that collect data on structural performance, and remote monitoring makes it possible to assess a dam's condition in real time without a physical presence at the site. Advanced data management systems allow owners to collect and keep track of large amounts of data, including instrumentation, inspection reports, maintenance, and more. These systems make it easier to assess a dam's safety, evaluate its condition over time, and prioritize and plan for repairs and improvements. Owners and regulators are beginning to use risk principles to manage dam safety. Most dam engineering and oversight has historically followed a standards-based approach. We establish rules for design events, loads, structural capacity, etc., based on empirical evidence and good practice developed over time. However, a standards-based approach is not well-suited for evaluating dam safety issues with significant complexity and uncertainty, like internal erosion, gate reliability, and human factors. Federal agencies, including the Federal Energy Regulatory Commission, the U.S. Army Corps of Engineers, and the Bureau of Reclamation, are all using risk-based principles to identify, analyze, and manage dam safety issues. Risk-informed decision-making attempts to quantify the probability and consequences of various concerns, evaluate if risks are tolerable, and if not, whether alternative risk reduction measures are justified. It's important to note that many of the practices and considerations discussed in this video go beyond what may be required by state and federal regulations, as owners recognize the extent of their legal and ethical responsibilities. The Association of State Dam Safety Officials has free resources available to help owners operate and maintain their dams safely. Contact your State Dam Safety Program for additional help, and be sure to check out ASDSO's website at damowner.org for more information.